Greetings. This is a CyBri broadcast updating you on the latest and greatest developments in the world of science and technology. These are the cutting-edge advances in overcoming human disabilities with the aid of the following technologies. Concentrating deeply, Kathy Hutchinson stared at the tumbler of coffee on the table in front of her wheelchair. A cup-shaped dome on her head powered her small neural implant, capturing signals from her motor cortex as she thought about holding the mug. Slowly, the robot arm began to move. The elbow swung forward, the wrist turned and the fingers clasped around the cup. A moment later, she took a long drink, the first time since her stroke 15 years ago that she enjoyed a sip of coffee without a caregiver's help. This feat is part of an ongoing clinical trial using a neural interface system, the first demonstration and the first published study of people using their own brain signals to control a robotic arm. It's a major breakthrough for neuroscience and engineering, and it could someday help people with paralysis live more independently. Previous research by the same team proved that paralyzed patients could control a computer cursor with their thoughts. This technology and this latest breakthrough is known as brain gate. The brain gate array, which is implanted on the motor cortex, comprises nearly 100 electrodes on a chip the size of a baby aspirin. It targets only a few dozen neurons. The technology is still a long way from widespread use, but its creators, Donahue and Hochberg, said in a news conference they were encouraged by its success so far. There's been significant progress in bringing sight to the blind in recent years, and this looks set to continue that miraculous trend. Scientists at Stanford University have invented a subretinal photodiode implant for people who have lost their vision due to degenerative retinal diseases. Existing tech involves batteries and wires, but the new implant works without such crude appendages. Instead, it's activated by near-infrared beams projected by a camera that's mounted on glasses worn by the patient. Those beams then stimulate the optic nerve to allow light perception, motion detection, and even basic shape awareness. The glasses also have an onboard camera that records what the patient sees. By far one of the greatest challenges of sign language has been to translate it for the general population that wouldn't know where to begin a conversation with the deaf. These Cornell University engineering students used their final project time this past semester to close this gap in one of the more practical solutions seen to date. Their prototype glove uses accelerometers, contact sensors and flex sensors to translate complex finger gestures from the American Sign Language alphabet into spoken letters. After converting hand positions to digital signals, the test unit both speaks out the resulting letters and sends them to a computer, where they can be used for anything from a game to, presumably, constructing whole sentences. Along with being accurate, the Cornell work is even designed with a mind towards how it would work in the real world, as the glove and its transmitter are both wireless and powered by 9-volt batteries. Update complete.